is a babe. Babe with the power. Power of voodoo.
Voodoo.
You do.
Do what?
Remind me of the babe.
I saw my baby.
What could I do?
My baby's love had gone and left my baby blue. Nobody knew what kind of magic spell to use.
Mine is new.
Oh, what with dovetails,
thunder or lightning.
And baby said,
trying hard as they could try.
What could I do?
My baby's heart had gone and left my baby blue. Nobody knew what.
boss has demanded that I start sending in weekly audio logs. Today was a terribly warm 19 degrees out. I went out to pick up some things from the store. I believe that's all I have to say for now. There's a terrible little blister on my foot. I think I might need to bandage it up. I'm picking the loose skin off it now. Next time, I'll make sure to record this before I go live. I fear that this may be getting picked up on the microphone. Alright, I believe that it will... Yes, I believe that will do it for now. Alright, here we go. And... vent. So how about that new model, huh? Yeah, boil Lansing Stream, boil Lansing Stream. That shit's almost bleeding. I picked off too much. Oh my god, it's White Smurf. Yep. I very specifically made sure to preserve the, new model. I worked on this a lot. I actually had to completely re-rig the, mouth last night. Okay, let's get the whole thing on screen. Ruined your boil edging. No. Watch this. I had to do some fucking trickery. I have to actually lean for the model to lean. I don't just need to like it was doing before I got all that nonsense going. Those are pants. Now watch this. If I hit 5 on my numpad, that's not it. Nope. It is 4 the one? Oh, brother. Okay. Create new... Yeah, whatever. All right, so this one, 4. This one, 5. This one, 6. There we go. I had to set up all my goddamn expressions again. So if I hit 5, the jacket's here. It was annoying to get this right. There's this. Yep, here we go. Let's get back into position. We have a jar that I need to prep. I don't have a big winter parka. At this point, rigging one would be too much effort. It took me fucking a full day to get the jacket right. Oh shit, music's over. Here we go. All right, let's get the Fate Grand Order wiki up. It's a new month. You know what that means? It's new jar time. You know what? Individually setting that up for the thing would be too much of a hassle. I'm going to where's my display capture? Back in my day. No, I'm not doing the old man bit, not this time. Going, there we go. So those of you who have been here on the first of the month prior know, every month I put someone else in the jar. It's just a matter of deciding who's going on the wheel this time. It's Sunday. It is currently Sunday right now. Sunday the 2nd. You don't need to see that spoiler for the slop we're getting down to tonight. I'm not even going to stream any more Fortnite this season, because they nerfed the cars, and that was the only fucking fun thing about the season. Alright, let's see. You know what, yeah, let's line up another bar guest for the jar. Fuck it, why not? The third one. Fuck it, why not? I wanted to get the new model to look pretty damn close to the ref sheet, and I feel like I did a good job. Like, it's not exactly one for one, but like, a little deviation's fine. Oh, yep. I picked the skin off my blister and now I regret it because that shit's starting to hurt. I am a dumbass. Okay, so you may notice that little path, the road to partner in my title. That's going to be there presumably for the rest of my career. If I'm lucky, and if people tend to enjoy my stuff going forward, I'll hit it eventually. But until then, that's just gonna be there. Of course, once I get partner, I'll be able to do some very lovely stuff. But the biggest plus is more emote slots. More emotes for my wonderful, wonderful viewers to use. Alright, so let's see. Who do we have lined up for now? UDK, Bargust, and Durga. Let's poke around the assassin class. Ooh. Itchy eyeball. Of course, here's a topic that has been previously very well covered, very well reminded. This summer, I have about a list of 5 games that I'd like to marathon right up to the end. What's the chibi model doing? 47%! That's insane. Nuts. Insane. More rigging work for me. Is that what you want? Evil fucked up chat members. Alright, who else am I nominating for the jar? Yeah! Yes! Me and my clutch of eggs contributing all of our points to force you to rig another model. Yes! Can you turn down the air conditioning? It's fucking with my cold blood. Yes!
I'm sorry, I totally just turned you into a snake person for that. That's evil, that's fucked up, I'm terrible. Who do I want to put in there? You know what, yeah, let's get some old man yaoi going. less fucked up and evil than me, yes! Come, streamer, enter my cold, moist cave! This is the rock where I sit and soak up the sun for most of the day, yes! Thank you. It means a lot. I feel like this is my best rigging job as well as the best overall job I've done. Yeah, I actually like went out of my way to do the physics for the earring, sorry. So, an interesting thing about the mouth animation, I'm using VTube Studio's advanced lip sync feature, which means I had to set up a silence parameter. So when that silence parameter is maxed out, you know, it works like a normal mouth. But when it's, you know, when it's all the way off, like when I'm talking, it locks the mouth in the closed position, like the closed neutral position. And the blend shapes I have for the different consonant, the different vowels, like ah, e, o, audio jungle. Those take over, which allows it to have a slightly better way of doing the lip sync, where it doesn't rely on the actual movements of my mouth. It relies on the actual words I'm speaking. This is an option that everyone who uses VTube Studio has, and it allows me to completely cut out an iPhone from my workflow, which is phenomenal. Because I hate Apple, and I think people should start firebombing their offices. I had to learn how to do this just so that I could use one less Apple product in my life. I also referenced a few of the example models for how much my head should be turning. So now it's not awkwardly warping my face heavily in one direction or the other. And I think it looks nice. I think that's very nice. I think that's very fun. It may be the hubris talking, but I think this might be my best model thus far. Like, if you go back on my YouTube channel, you go back to, like, season one, compared to that, this model looks professional quality. I think it's all right for me to say that. Like, the painterly style I was going with back then, not bad. I just didn't have the skill to pull it off and make it work. Now, the style I'm going with, the way I'm doing it, looks phenomenal. The fact that I mostly taught myself how to do this, and the fact that it looks really good, really goes to show how much, like, work I've put into making this work. I need to get some music on it. I'm going to go insane. Let's see. I'm not putting on Weezer's Blue Album again. I still have the nonsense stuck in my head. No, get that out of here. No Weezer. We are not wheezing. Let's see. Hey, you know what? Another Light by Red Vox is a decent album. Let's put that on. Jabronathan Michael and Vine Sauce Vinny, do not sue me. Listen, I already hate the fact that I had to listen to Buddy Holly at least 100 times to get it right for when I recorded my entire like cover album. Like, every time I see that specific shade of blue, I instinctually hear just I can't look at the Fortnite skybox anymore. Like, I look up and they're just there, looming over me like the Titans in Attack on Titan. What was I looking for? Oh, right. Someone to put in the jar. Usually I go up to 12 selections, selected participants for the jar wheel. So I guess I'll throw Ryogi and Hassan of the Serenity in there. I've already done the Old Man of the Mountain. We don't need to put Grandpa in the jar again. Besides, there's other grandpas I could be putting in the jar. Like, for as many, like, nice hot women there are in this in Fate Grand Order, there are plenty of nice hot old men in there. I really appreciate it. Let's see. We're in the Berserker section now. Crazy fucked up choices. You know what? I'll put Ryko in for a second chance. Fuck it. Why not? A little track called The Beginning of Something Really Excellent. I'll check that out. I'll check that out later. Kijo Koyo, yep. No, you've already been in the jar, actually. Man.jpg. I know already that's a character from another one of Nasu's visual novels. I think it's Mahotsukai no Yoru. But it's just really funny seeing this normal fucking guy. Like, he's just standing there. Guy.jpif. See what is oh my fucking god. Whoa. Let's put that away. Put that back in the box. That'll be our little secret. Now let's check out the foreigner class. Have they added anyone new here? Nope. Just the character from Mahotsukai no Yoru. Can you put me in the jar? Do you have a PNG you'd like me to put in the jar? I'll put you on the wheel. Let's see. Okay, I'll put you on the wheel for getting put in the jar then. There's a specific outfit for Aoko that's really funny to me. That's just not in Fade Grand Order, but I think I'll put her on the wheel just so I could put that in there. It's the old Melty Blood design where she was just in a white t-shirt and some nice jeans. All right, friend request accepted. Welcome aboard. Knock Nariyov with Yarandu. Think I've already had Queen Mob in there. God, but I don't know what the fuck's wrong with the Fade Grand Order devs, but whatever they're doing, giving Abigail Williams outfits like that really makes me uncomfortable. I don't know what's wrong with them. Hey, you know, let's put Tenochtitlan in there. Shielder. There's only one shielder. Oh, beast. I forget. Is there like some bad fucked up Yep, stage two. Okay. Wait. That's not even the one I was thinking of. The one that's in Fate Grand Order Arcade, where they put all their best designs for some fucking reason. You see, look. Child-shaped character, clothes like that. Connect the dots. And if I remember right, back to Abigail Williams. Actual child character, uncomfortably revealing swimsuit. Like, at least stage one's the worst one here. Like, this one's a bit better. This one's like a normal swimsuit. Fate Grand Order at its worst. Well, while we're back here, let's put Van Gogh in the box, in the running for the wheel. Yeah. Same series famous for their awful Jack the Ripper design that they overuse, while ignoring the actually fucking cool Jack the Ripper reinterpretation from Fate Strange Fake. Now fucking check this out. Very powerful designs for Van Gogh here. Hell yeah. Like, at least, despite being pretty flat, Van Gogh is, like, shaped like an adult. I respect that. I respect that hustle. Let's check out the saber section. Mia from Dot Hack IMOQ. Let me see. You need to understand that I can't just do this with any character. I need to have like a decent quality, like JPEG or PNG or something. Like, I can't just put, I don't want to spend like 20 minutes cropping out the background. Well, I'll check her wiki page for if there's any other appearances, like in Project X Zone or something. Let's see, where are your... There does not appear to be any other appearances. Thank you, Shinkai Kaiju. I worked really hard on it. Oh, my neck's giving me all kinds of trouble. But let me see. Thank you very much, Ava, for the transparent image you've given me. I can very easily dump that in the jar if you happen to win the wheel. Remember, it's not guaranteed. All these characters are getting put on a wheel. This is the normal format for these jar creation streams. Let's see, who else do I want to put? You know what? Fuck it, put Jason in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11. Have I had Summer Ibuki in the jar yet? Let me move this over here so you can't see my nefarious porn folders. You know what? I say that, but it's very... I'm very open about the fact that I don't save porn to my computer. There are no nefarious porn folders. Go home. All right, where's my jar collection? Here we go. There's only one Ibuki. Only one. And it's not even the summer one, I don't think. WebP is the scourge of men? Yeah, you fucking know it. Awful, awful format. We need to kill whoever made it. Oh. Oh. Where's Summer Ibuki? Berberker? Where's my wife? There it is. There she is. Alright, so that constitutes 12. Here we go. I'm back here less than 24 hours later. I sat here a little bit last night and I used the wheel to decide whether or not I was... What season of Super Sentai I'd watch next. The wheel decided Q-Ranger, and I started, and it's pretty good. Alright, let's see. So that's... Jason. Summer Ibuki. Van Gogh. Tenochtitlan. That's not how you spell that. Summer, get cold. Durga, old man Li Shuwen, not to be confused with young Li Shuwen, who is also pretty fun. Assassin. Just send them, send the links to me. I have an extension that allows me to save WebP as PNG. I hate the fact that I have to have that extension. It should be an automatic function where if you download WebP, it gets turned into whatever preferred file format you set. But no, I have to take the fucking WebP. Assassin Ryogi. Serenity, Sun, Raiko, again. Aoko. Chat member, Ava, Fangs, Mia, IMOQ. Special guest, secret surprise. All right. Advanced options, color theme, pastel, seconds to spin. Let's put a full minute. Oh yes, thank you very much. I've received the links. All right, here we go. Apply wheel changes. Ooh, huh. Whoa. My neck's all kinds of fucked up right now. All right, now everybody's favorite Roger Event. Spin that wheel! White Smurf, here we go. All right, we have many great choices on the wheel today. Let's see what the wheel decides. This is a technique I use to remove all agency in decision making, and thus all indecision. In very rare cases where I actually actively dislike the choice, I will re-roll. Hang on, let's see. It's winding down, Happy Pride! Of course, for Gay Month, we get the man. We're putting a man in the jar. All right, which one of these do I like most? This one. Listen, it would have been really funny for me to pick, like, the NES sprite of Jason from Friday the 13th, developed by Atlus, by the way. But I chose not to. Put that white man in there. You know what I'm talking about. You don't need to see what folders I have saved. Desktop. Downloads. Save underscore WebP, this one. Well, now one. The Smurfs NES full soundtrack again. Yeah, you know what? Why not? Remember fucking Goku Smurf from that stream? Like, there was a Goku Smurf that Hefty joined the military. Fucking unhinged. You had to be there. What? The fucking Smurf hag? Hello? Yeah, here we go. So we duplicate this layer. Boom. Clipping mask. There we go. Now the fun part. Just clip these parts out. Take these parts, edit, transform, just stretch them down. There we go. And after we finish preparing this, I have plenty of nice, hot, wet slop for you to enjoy. I grabbed a bunch of free Steam horror games. A couple of which seemed interesting, and the rest were ones I had literally never heard about. It's gonna be a nice, fun evening. Free Transform. It's not Friday. Why are you saying it's Friday? The fact that you showed up at all means the world to me, Shock Attack. Thank you so much. It's not Friday. It's Sunday. It's Sunday. I will not let you gaslight me on this. It's Sunday. It's Sunday. It's Sunday. It's Sunday. The calendar right here says it is Sunday. Ava, why are you being a little practical jokester on me? Why are you doing this? Who's paying you? Right, file, save as. JSON jar, here we go. You're telling me you're being a little goofster, a little goofster, gavster, wacky little fella. For free. You're in it for the love of the game. I respect the grustle. The funny little slime. Yeah. I'm glad I turned on the emotes dropping on my head through VTube Studio. It's very funny. What do I do? Oh, all right. I'm changing out the jar. Here we go. Boom. A big old look at that. While we do that, I'm going to turn off display capture. No, I don't want to turn that back on. There we go. All right, so let's get that swapped over. And swap over to games and demos. You know something that like mildly annoys me? When people in comment sections are like using the same stupid fucking moron vocabulary to avoid censorship that like the people in the video I was commenting on say, like sewer slide. Brother, this is a text format. You can say suicide. You can say suicide. You can talk about people killing themselves. You're not gonna get banned by... Yeah, like... It also pisses me off, like, Creepcast, a podcast I watch that, reads creepypastas has been, like, saying unalive, sewer slide, grape, and it's like, you're talking about Jeff the Killer. Jeff the Killer. Why are you talking like that? This is a fucking story where people on skateboards jump a fence and start open firing guns at a child's birthday party. Why are you talking like that? Yeah, like, it's very much an infantilizing experience to hear like these grown men, one of which spent like 3 or 4 hours talking about Blood Meridian, and one of which has made some honestly really funny but fucked up cartoons, just talking like 12-year-olds on TikTok. You know? These guys have very profitable Patreons. It's fine. One of them's been repeatedly sponsored by Bad Dragon, and I don't fucking know how. Like, you would think You would think, you know, Meat Canyon would not... Dude, I fucking hate Bad Dragon. Not because they make what is a functionally equivalent to animal genitals, but because they charge you so fucking much for everything. Like, you know, shove whatever you want up your ass, just don't pay $500 for it. Just don't pay $500 for whatever you're putting inside you, you know? Alright, so this first game, all these are free on Steam, IVRI. Overpriced for the quality, and also they molded toys off real animals. Yeah. Like, I don't know what I expected from the Dragon Penis Company. Maybe I expected a little decency, but that's assuming a lot on my part. I will admit. What do you mean I turned game capture off? Is that why it's not showing? Oh! Sorry, I'm reevaluating some things. Wake up. Roger, you need to wake up. The new model reveal nightmare again. God damn it. Like, listen, I'll reserve any judgmental comments I may or may not have about people who fantasize about animal genitals, because it's not my job to ask these questions and make these judgments, and frankly, it shouldn't be my job. You've been in a coma for 47 years. Now I know you're fucking with me. Because my family wouldn't keep me alive for 47 years. They'd give up. They're too poor to do that. They'd give up after 3 years. Oh. Ooh. No, I sleep in a very nice little... I sleep in a single mattress on the floor. No box spring. Single mattress on the floor, covered in blankets. I argued that I shouldn't have a sheet on my bed because they make me uncomfortable. But I begrudgingly accepted because it made it easier to clean. Actual for real. I've been planning on getting a Japanese style futon so I could have a nice little area in my room where during the day I set up a TV or something, roll up my futon and put it away in the closet.
Welcome aboard Erinys 43, the first intergalactic space station created by the Inter-Astrian Vitality Reconnaissance Initiative.
I don't like the fact that there's a stamina bar. I think there's going to be a fucked up creature over around here somewhere.
The garden's been alright since you left. Well, Aurelia has been struggling with the change of seasons, but that's not too bad.
I'm stuck!
I'd say they'd be doing better with you here, but I know I can't have you all to myself. Or the plants either. So I'll keep taking care of things back home while you take care of things out there in space.
Listen, I can only make wild guesses at what quality of bed Billy and the prototype are having.
After all, the values of ivory
since they get to live with the manager back at his big fancy castle / corporate headquarters. But hey, I guess that's what I get for being the experiment. I was told they're finally going to be wrapping up soon.
Entry 4,
This is the final year. This is the final 2 months of the experience of the experiment. I don't know what data they're going to be collating since everything went off the rails, but you know what? That's fine. When is MCR going to break up? I don't know. I don't listen to My Chemical Romance. I don't know. Let's see. I don't care about the story enough to actually listen to these, and the developers should have known to put subtitles in.
No, that's not right. This isn't the first day. It might not even be the first month. Samsa didn't wake me up at first. The others that he did wake up, the aeronauts, the physicists, the specialists we had on board, all of them are no longer with us. I understand why he did what he did. Not just because he explained it to me. I'm sorry for not understanding sooner, but I do now.
All right, here we go. Where am I gonna go? Gonna make ramen? Enjoy your ramen. It's been a while since I actually bought a pack of instant ramen. I should get some next time I go grocery shopping. I don't practice Santeria. Ain't got no crystal ball. I had $1 million and I don't spend it all. God, I should do a cover of that song. I still promised my Tumblr followers, oh, I'm gonna do a cover of Lifetime Achievement Award. And I still haven't actually finished the cover for it. That's been stuck in my backlog for a while. Because it's still too fucking hard.
Captain's log, entry 3. Virgil didn't come back after the last split. At first, we thought he was caught up working on the device. So we waited. Until he never came. Until we got restless and left to go look for him ourselves.
That I see you looking at me. I know you want it, but I can't provide it because it's too fucking difficult for some reason. I'm having trouble. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's fair.
I got careless. I should have been paying attention.
All right.
I was so caught up in the argument that I didn't notice Petra leaving a note about investigating the station before she was gone. I looked everywhere for her. I checked every place.
All right, I gotta figure out how to do this.
I even had Samsa search the station for her, but he didn't find anything other
than... I need the opposite of that situation. Oh, there we go.
Roman doesn't rest until he's sure both of us are here, okay? And if I don't keep track of
I know for a fact I could definitely do either Ancient Aliens or Spiral of Ants right now. Over. It's over. The pheromones. That's it? That's the end of the game? I could probably also very well do the one about the no-eyed girl. I think that's the one. You know, after all the slop, I might sit down and do some karaoke. Who fucking cares? It's a special occasion. All right, let's see what's next. This next title, also free and also apparently very good. I've heard of this one before. That's how big this next one is. It's called Zardy's Maze. Zardy's Maze. Round of applause for Zardy's Maze. as a long time past reviewer, since the video that got him big, I'm kind of familiar with this one. I've seen Pastor's video on it. I know a lot about it. I know how to deal with some of the enemies. I don't remember it very well. I'm not a Zardy's Maze expert. I don't play it competitively. I'm not on the leaderboard. None of that. No, I just know a little about it. Yep. Uh-oh, there's pesky weeds growing throughout your cornfield. The largest weeds you ever seen. Better grab your trusty tools and give them a good whacking. Just make sure you keep track of where you're going when you enter the field. It's a bit of a maze out there. Wouldn't want to see you get lost, or worse. Remember, farmer, pumpkins have feelings too. When you smash them, their pumpkin friends get angry. Killing weeds is hard. Feel free to leave the field if things get stressful. Keep your flashlight charged. Some things can't be seen in the dark. Let's see what's popping in the options. Toggle sprint? No, I have the pinky strength of an Olympic medalist. Look sensitive. Yep, there we go. What just happened? Okay. Oh yeah, now we're talking. All right, so that's that. All right, here we go. Ah. I hear a hoe. I hear a hoe, and no, Chad member, it's not your mother. I'm fucking sorry. That's so mean-spirited. That's so fucked up. Oh, great. Oh, great. Oh no, oh no, oh no. I get the distinct feeling something's bad happening. Something bad is happening. Ah! The pumpkins are upset, yeah? The best and worst part of the Halloween season, cornfields, yep. I think I've had my fill. Can I go back to the menu? There we go. Huh. But yeah, there's an entire challenge menu. There's an entire set of challenges with all these silly little enemies, all sorts of stuff. Yeah, it's pretty nifty, and for like a free game, it's a free game with potentially like infinite amounts of playtime. There's an endless mode if you beat all the challenges. It's nuts. I'm just not that great at these kinds of games. With practice, I could probably get much better, but I don't feel like practicing a lot right now. Let's go right into something I've never heard about. Oh, welcome back, Ava. We're about to start something called The Complex Found Footage. Bulldak Ramen. Every time I've had that, it has caused me actual stomach trouble. I'm too weak for Bulldak Ramen. I'm so sorry. I once made the cheese flavor, but I left out the spicy part, and it was actually pretty decent. All right, let's get this going. Let's get this audio capturing. Torturing me with bulldog force feed. I don't consent to getting fed. I'm not into feeder stuff. Oh, I love yakisoba, especially if I make the, if I make the sauce myself, ooh, you know? Are you, am I sure? I clicked the fucking button. Start the game. The Complex, literally directly stealing the name for the backrooms that the famous Kane Pixels series uses. Speaking of, have you been watching that boy's oldest view stuff, phenomenal series. I really like it. Oh god, the motion blur is actively causing screen tearing. What do you mean I can't turn it off? I'll turn VSync on. Evil. I need to figure out how to make cheese sauce just so I can bump up the power of my noodles, of my noodle game. Free from ad hell, welcome back. Remember, every ad you view is another penny in my game. Yeah, Backrooms game. Not even like the one that's famous for having leaning be so strong that it's a speedrun strat, or one which I saw some really funny footage of called Backrooms Break, I think. Pools, I don't want to pay money for that. I don't want to pay money for that, and I feel bad pirating small indie games. Unless it's like Disco Elysium, where the company's like, yeah, fucking pirate it. Where the developers are like, yeah, don't pay for that. And even then, I don't want to go back to Disco Elysium until I figure out what stats are good for a Dale Cooper build. Just because I'm frustrated that the game was calling me a sad cop, just because I was being fucking polite. Like, if I can get over yourself, fuck off. Yeah, Inland Empire and then really good mental stats was generally the suggestions I was seeing. Let me try. Yep, that's slightly lemon flavored. Then again, it could be just that flavor of wall. Let's see what's in here. The backrooms definitely smell like cigarettes, and I'm feeling right at home there. White ball. Yep, that's drywall. Load-bearing drywall, to be specific. A very special type. Listen, there's no greater delicacy in the construction world than load-bearing drywall. All right, you can crouch. Load-bearing back walls. Yep, load-bearing back shots. How about that? Fucking load-bearing back shots. Fucking Christ. Okay. Here we go. My mind, this cave, so dark, no moon, no stars. Your fridge. You're gonna write that down with your fancy calligraphy pens, and you're gonna put that on your fridge. Is that how you're going to repay me for my worst joke of the year? You're gonna put it in big fancy letterings, and you're gonna get out your finest most expensive magnets just to put that up there on your fridge. If you do that, like, ping me in the photo of it on Tumblr. I'll reblog it. put the fan art tag on it. Who fucking cares? Load-bearing back shots. The walls are a little more orange in this room, I think. What's the pattern like? No pattern on them. Yep, tangerine. Ooh, that's a nice chair. Now, these chairs, these could use a little work, I think. I ain't a chair expert, but I don't think anyone's going to be able to sit on those. The legs are all warped and they look a little uneven. That one on the left. Right. That one on the right, someone could sit on that. No one's sitting in the one on the left. My mind's this cave, so dark, no moon, no stars, no stars, no sound. Oh yeah, have you heard? They found where the original Backrooms photo was taken. Yeah, they did. It was an RV racing building. No, an RC car racing building, to be accurate. You could go there and race your cool little cars. Fucking... This eliminates all fear I could have had from the Backrooms conceptually, because it's like, yeah, Cosmo Kiryu is there. He's doing a sub story. He'll protect me. Backrooms cart when? You I fucking hope so. Backrooms cart, and just like Nightmare cart, it's going to be really good, except for the battle mode that they're going to force you to do for the main progression type deal. Can I use one of these computers? But yeah, since now I know that people just be racing their RC cars in the back rooms, I feel perfectly safe. If a creature comes up to me, you know what's gonna happen? Cosmic Kiryu's gonna come out of nowhere, having just finished a race, and he's gonna save my ass. He's gonna punch the creature while it's trying to creature at me. He's gonna be like, whoa, that was a close call there. Yeah, Kiryu, nothing can harm Cosmic Kiryu. Tiger Drop negates all damage. So I pulled out some good old bread to defrost, because I ran out of hamburger buns. Yeah. I always felt the Backrooms should be like the black passages in House of Leaves, where you don't know what's chasing you and what's trying to assault you, but you do know that, you need to get out of there. Yeah, yeah. For me, when I saw the initial Backrooms post, when I was going around at first, I thought, oh, this is just like the 5-minute hallway from the Davidson report. You know, I thought they were going in a direction where it's like, oh yeah, nothing in there is actually real. like physically on the physical plane. It's purely like a psychosomatic type of thing. Where if you believe something is going to come and kill you, it's going to come and kill you. But if you think, oh, this is just a weird empty place, it's gonna, you know, yeah. Yeah, yeah, you guys get it. Like, while I appreciate, I can only appreciate the whole Backrooms wiki lore type deal in its utility as a way to exercise yourself creatively. But it also, at the same time, the Backrooms aren't the SCP wiki. You aren't that fucking guy, you know? Plus, like, the idea that, plus, like, stupid nonsense ideas like, oh, the only potable water in the Backrooms is almond water. Like, what does that even fucking mean? Explain your terms, brother. Like, what is almond water? Is it just water they extracted from almonds? I'd rather have the milk. Like, I appreciate the idea of giving an alien, otherworldly environment Listen, you show me an almond with tits, I'm gonna start suckling, dude. I just heard something clicking. All progress will be... What do you mean all progress will be lost? I just sat in this stupid fucking game for like... probably 20 or 30 minutes or something. Yeah, there is a critter in there. I want out. Where's Kiryu? Where's Cosmic Kiryu to save me? Like, I think the idea of the... I think a lot of the ideas that drive... The existence of the Backrooms Wiki are good. Like, it's a good outlet for people to write creatively. It's a fun way to flesh out a setting and project something that's evidently many people consider interesting onto an otherwise like alien unrelatable concept. And I enjoy that for its utility. I just don't enjoy it for its execution, because it's like, we already have the SCP Wiki. Why not make a wiki for a game that doesn't exist? Yeah, parking lots. Like, with the recent, relatively recent, Super Eye Patch Wolf video on video games that don't exist, I want to see someone take the concept of Vermis, a guide for a game that doesn't exist. I want to see someone take that concept and apply it to the format of a wiki. I think that'd be fun. I wish I had the hosting ability to make it myself. But I don't. But I think that'd be a really fun way to do something like the Backrooms, or like space type things. Because it's like, oh, what kinds of areas do you find a lot of in modern video games? Areas that normally contain NPC characters. And parking lots and such. Areas that are very easy to end up in without any other characters. And where it will just feel wrong. And I think making a fictional video game based entirely around those types of games, no, not games, those types of areas, and then making a wiki for this game, explaining, not even explaining the systems and such, literally just going over like, ah, yes, here's this area, here's what you can find here, and here's the puzzle that you can do to unlock like other parts of this area and stuff like that. Like, I mentioned this earlier, but I think Yeah. Like, we've, like, liminal spaces have been popular, I think, long enough now that it's time for us to start looking for other things, looking for other ways to use them in new contexts. Because keeping them the same all the time, while that could be fun, it also is a little counterintuitive. Like, there's no fucking way it's gonna grow that huge if you just keep doing the nonsense, you know? Let's see. What am I moving on to? Like, for example, and don't tell anyone I'm, this is just between the six of us. I'm working on a little something special, something before I get to my full main, Digital Devil Saga inspired RPG, where it's just a little adventure game set entirely in within the building for a storage unit company. And I think that's a very fun idea. Anything can be in those storage units. Even a boat. All right, let's see what else, what's next? Like, it's fun, just, I've only seen it used once before, and the ending for that game kind of sucked, and I want to go in a different direction compared to that. All right, this next game, this next first chapter for a game, you may have heard about this. It's a bit old. Yep, Scary Pac-Man. Scary Pac-Man. This and Zardy's Maze are the only two games on this list where I'm fairly certain more than three people have heard about them. It ate my mouse. It's a bit of an old game. I'm setting this to easy because I'm a bitch. Here we go. I can't. Is there motion blur? It keeps eating my mouse. So I believe the rest of these cost money, but the first one.
Thank you. dark deception.
Whoa, art gallery. Hey, Puffy. I gotta remove that fucking joke. I gotta remove that fucking joke from my brain. Otherwise, I'm just, every time I do the whoa voice, it's just gonna launch the hey puppy. Hey puppy, I just got back from the Steam sale. Do you want a copy of Rust? Are you? You haven't seen it, have you? You haven't seen it, have you?
Got back from Popeyes.
No. You are not playing in the browser without me. I'm putting this on the main... Chunky, bring up the display capture.
Got back from Popeyes. Do you want a bite of my chicken breast? Here, puppy. I know you have a bite. Watch me.
This chicken's bussing at the end. Fuck, evil video, and it's stuck in my brain forever. It's never going away. Get that out of here. Get that shit out of here. Hey, puppy. Just got back from Popeyes. Thanks, man. No problem. Anything for you, dear viewer. Hey, puppy. Just got back from Popeyes. Well, what was the version I did? -1 per people holding hands. Yep. I think I did a variation on that during the Gregory Horror Show streams, where it was like, "Hey puppy, just got back from the Army Recruitment Center. Here, I got you a sign-up form. Do you need help signing it? Follow my lead. Watch." All right. Beers. Old woman. Now we're fucking talking. Hell yeah.
Oh, another one. How nice to have some company again.
Overanimated old one. Armored Core 6, yeah. Yeah, you did. You pulled that one right out of my brain. You did that for me, thank you.
Come over here. Let's have a look at you.
I'm very normal right now. I'm very normal right now. I'm very, very, very normal right now. I'm very normal right now. I'm supremely normal right now. Egg manifested, yeah. Lysandra, what? Let me see. Show me more images. League of Legends website, show me more images. All right. Not sufficiently hag-coated yet. Get some wrinkles on that face. That's what I want to see. Put it in your microwave, make it real hot like a soup or a dip. We call it heat and sip. Very tasty and healthy too. Granny Cream's the butter ice cream. Thank you, Hot Dad, for many great songs, including this and the one about Hardee's. Old man, I'm more into guys my own age.
You disappoint me now. You really do. So many fears.
What have I done to deserve this? Why are you... No! Listen, I'm not joking. I'm not joking. As soon as I heard that Cyberpunk 2077 has a real bona fide old woman sex scene, immediately the back of my mind just Granny Cream's hot butter ice cream. Call it heat and sip.
Don't look so confused. I know everything you've got hidden in that brain of yours. I know all the terrible things you've done. So many good intentions laid to rest.
Listen. Listen. We don't talk. Listen, old woman, we don't talk about what happened in that Denny's. We don't fucking talk about it, okay? Thought you'd be bigger. Full disclosure, I have had zero sexual encounters, and especially zero with old women, unfortunately. You may now point and laugh at me. Alright, get this out of here.
But now your time has come, and here you are, to grovel and beg. You can't go back. Only death awaits you there now.
I'm not sure how I feel about the fact that her mouth is severely overanimated. It's like kind of uncanny.
Fear not, love. You've got potential. I see it in you. And I can help change your fate. But if you want a new life, you're going to have to suffer quite a bit to get it.
Well, listen, the things that happened in that Denny's... The RCMP is still looking for who did that, and they don't know it's me. We call it heat and sip.
The pieces to a powerful ring are hidden in nightmares behind each of these portals. Find them and bring them to me, and you'll get your wish.
I am holding myself together. Awaiting you here. Volumetric shit compressor, go!
Clock's ticking.
Granny Cream's hot butter ice cream. Monkey business, hell yeah.
What a charming little hotel. Bring back any memories?
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Whoa. Hell yeah! Hell yeah! Now you didn't just see me get spooked by that cardboard cutout, okay? You may think you did, but you didn't. Fucked up ape! Fucked up ape! Fucked up ape! So starting tomorrow on Monday, we officially begin our Mario and Luigi Partners in Time playthrough, and that's going to run Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday every week until I finish the game. And after that, We're doing Bowser's Inside Story, Nintendo's famous Vore game. And after that, Kingdom Hearts. Immediately after Bowser's Inside Story, Kingdom Hearts. Which is going to take up a lot of time because Kingdom Hearts is a dog shit game. It's so... It's not great. Not phenomenal. It takes so long to do fucking anything in that game. Yep. And after that, Chulip, Chibi Robo to chill games to ride out the end of the summer on.
Now listen closely. See those floating bits of crystal? Those are soul shards. Fragments of human spirit scattered throughout the halls of this little maze. Each crystal is a remnant of one who has met their end here. Gather them all, and the first ring piece will be yours. One more thing. You're not alone. There are monsters in here, and they're looking for you. Here, you'll need this. It can detect each shard's location. It was left by the last guest to disappoint me here.
Yay, old woman gave me an iPad.
Just not a very fast runner. Enough instruction. Break those boards and let's get this party started.
Ah, yeah, you guys like Pac-Man, right? How did that ape not touch me? Pac-Man satiates my need to eat floor candy while being chased by demons. Yep. Oh! I've seen everything I need. They've sold me on this game. Old woman with big cleavage. Silly apes. That's all I need. Next time you're seeing this game, it's gonna be the full game. The full fucking thing. Listen, they underestimated my standards. Do you like Lady Dimitrescu? So much so that even after the part where she turns into a big fucked up dragon, I still would. Listen. I had to step away from the computer during the parts where she would pick Ethan Winters up like he was a little action figure. That's how much we're talking here. Yeah. Fucked up evil monster woman form. Jackpot. That's what we're talking about. Alright, we have... two more games to get through. Listen, all I'm saying... I would let Lady Dimitrescu harvest my blood. That's all I'm saying on the matter. All right, next is a negative atmosphere ER. More specifically, negative atmosphere emergency room, the full thing. It appears to be some sort of surgery game. I used to play surgery flash games a lot when I was a kid. Fun fact. I'd open the game and it's like, oh, I'm removing bone. No, Sammy, you have a very positive atmosphere. I would trust you with my wallet, and that's saying a lot, considering I value my wallet more than my life. Listen, someone steals my wallet, they can steal my identity. Someone takes my life, well, that's it. Sammy wants to be in, like, a wet, dry world. Does Sammy want a negative emotional atmosphere? Too bad. Now, I would pick you up like one of them ferrets and walk around with your lower half just wiggling and swinging around. Oh, where's my phone? It's all the way over there. And then I'm just gonna open up Tumblr on my. Best played with a gamepad. Oh no. Yeah, that's right. I would pick you up and hold you like a ferret. I'd be walking around, gesticulating, talking like I usually do. I talk with my hands a lot of the time. And your lower half would just be swanging and dangling. Technically speaking, all living organisms are wet, dry worlds of some fashion. Accessibility, big text size. There we go, just so that's not blowing out my fucking ears. Speaking of wet, dry worlds, let's get into some.
Hey, can you hear me? Dr. Edwards here. The Spider B CPU needs to be calibrated.
Alright, here we go. I wasn't joking, by the way. Right after this, I'm going to go to my usual torrent site and acquire an illegal pirated copy of Cyberpunk 2077 with the DLC, just because I heard there's an old woman sex scene in it. This is real. I'm going to do this. I'm not going to do it on stream because, like, I don't want the feds knowing what site I use. But, like, if you know, you know. It's the same site I got my copy of Baldur's Gate 3 off of.
Right. The visual feed seems to be working. I'll be activating the operational UI for the machine.
Look at my little hands.
SpiderHot UI options enabled, Dr. Edwards.
Okay. I know some of you were trained in different academies and programs. I want
heartaches by the number.
To a familiar standard and make sure everything is tweaked right. In the operation room, we cannot afford mistakes. Okay. System all set up?
I'm like a little crustacean of some kind. Robot crustacean.
Right where Mr. Pineapple is. Good. Now focus on the pineapple. Zoom in, zoom out, and observe the patient. I'll be moving the laser pointer at different points.
and getting the system to highlight each spot. Move to each of them, please.
Here we go.
Now that we have observed the patient,
yeah, here we go.
No visible issues. Mr. Pineapple needs further examination. I want you to scan the point of interest. Sierra, ready scanner.
Scanner is active and online, Dr. Edwards.
And this is why we're not eating this pineapple.
Ooh.
There seems to be something in there.
What's going on with this?
Sample. Utilize the sample tool and collect the sample. Sierra, enable fluid sample protocol.
Fluid sample collection enabled, Dr. Edwards.
Navigate to the points of interest and collect the fluid sample from our fruit friend here.
Would you fuck the face-stealing granny from Fear and Hunger? Maybe. I'd consider it.
Seems to be healthy, despite the oblong growth inside. The botany lab will need to answer for that at some point. Seems we've seen what there is to be seen. Let's cut it open now, see what truth lays inside. Line yourself up with the green zone. Be careful, that laser is powerful and can burn and boil easily.
Okay, yeah.
Good, good. I think this diagnostic calibration is sufficient. Just in time, too.
It's not the worst thing that could happen. I'll take my chances. Of
Sierra,
very powerful.
Diagnostic mode. Initiate operation procedure.
Operation procedure initialized.
Yeah, it's a decent game. It's decent. I like this.
Refugees picked up from the Hecate 5 mining station brought along the usual...
I'll do one more... operation, and then we're going to the final game. We're gonna break through into the 2 hour mark soon. You know what? I'll go 3 hours. I'll tack some karaoke on the end. Why not? It's a special day.
Sierra, compile patient profile of Zhao Feng. Lucy, could you debrief about the crime scene?
Was on my usual patrol route. And noticed that a maintenance door was open. Feng's leg was...
Let's listen to what they're saying.
Upon closer inspection, I discovered Feng had signs of struggle. And his neck and face was discolored. Neck had marks on it as well. I secured the area and called in for backup to get forensics on site.
Actually, where's my phone? Let me go grab it.
Evidence on site.
Minimal
amounts of blood on the floor. Feng smelled like nicotine.
Sierra, status on patient profile compilation.
Five new
patient
notes. Ooh.
Compiled. Sending to crew members. Initiate spider scanning protocol, Doctor.
Thank you, Sierra. Proceed with spider scanning protocol.
Yeah, it's very chill so far, and you know what? It's free on Steam, so you don't even need to pay for it. Very nice, very nice. Okay.
Scan initiated. Stand by.
As a surgery game, I like this much more than Surgeon Simulator. Because it's actually fucking trying. Oh my god, don't get me started on how... Don't get me started on... Don't get me started on how angry it gets me that there's surgeon games where the joke is that it's like, oh, it's hard to play. Ooh, it's fucking... Come on, man. Actually fucking try, dude. Like, I know it's something stupid to get mad at, but, like, really? Really? Come on. And then this one's actually, like, putting in the work to make it feel nice and fluid and enjoyable, and I appreciate it greatly. Oh, I know how to make you guys really fucking uncomfortable. All right, make sure you keep a close eye on it. Oh, aw.
Substances found in Fung's bloodstream indicate nicotine, cannabis, and authorized sleeping medications.
He's confirmed for contraband substances. He had in his pockets a vapor inhaler with a variety of cartridges for both nicotine, cannabis, and the smoke buddy.
Duly noted. Include that information in your report.
Of course, sir. Little to no evidence was found on site of the perpetrators. Whoever did this definitely didn't...
Nice intestines. I wanna keep them.
We'll find them. Sierra, initiate autopsy procedure.
Autopsy protocol engaged.
I wanna keep them. Fucking sorry. Like evil bit, fucked up bit. Clothing removal in progress. They're not gonna let us see the penis.
Barristan is on the comlink, doctor.
Would
you like to speak to him?
Yes, patch him in. He can listen in as we examine.
Roger, one moment.
What?
You have Xiaofeng an autopsy doctor? Yes. Beginning examination of the body as we speak.
Click to inspect bro. Click to inspect groin. Oh, hey, what the fuck? What are we seeing here?
Stipulate the subject's tissue suffered from hypoxia, Dr. Edwards.
A wire, by the looks of it. Whoever did this knew what they were doing. We have a premeditated murder on our hands.
Yeah, I think, I'm stuck. Hello? Bottom surgery simulator. Yep. That's fucked up and evil. I'm sorry. Feet!
Judging by the bruising and swelling as well, it seems the whole leg was struck incredibly hard. Some kind of blunt object. Inferring from the crime scene, likely two suspects who came up behind Zhao.
One of them striking his leg, Zhao clutched the doorframe as he fell.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I see. I understand. I think I get it. Nice nipples, bro. Alright, I'm gonna need to see your back. Alright. Let's flip him over. I'm normal and I can be trusted with a view of his back.
Examining the back now. More bruising.
The people parsing the data for this are going to be like, why'd the robot look at his dick five times? Yep, that's the back. Oh, what? I don't like that. That scared me.
It seems like we have up to two culprits, one or both of them being incredibly strong and brutal. Judging by the injuries while leaving no fingerprints or other identifying evidence, it's as you said, Lance. We're dealing with premeditated murder.
I love how bad the subtitles are. Like, they extend off the screen.
Understood.
Oh yeah, you guys ever watch that Leprechaun 5 in the Hood movie? If you watch it with subtitles, you'll notice that there's a lot more R's than the actual dialogue calls for. And I don't know why they're like that.
Zhao Feng signed TRH's waiver, and no other documents were found.
Not surprising given how young he is. Sierra, let's begin the incisions for internal examination.
This gameplay feature is not implemented yet. What do you mean? Yeah, Leprechaun 5 in the Hood, where he smokes weed and he says verbatim, "A friend with weed is a friend indeed, but a friend with gold is the best, I'm told." And then at the end, he raps. Very powerful. Very powerful movie. There's also like a trans drag queen in there. Like, this was before it was like, you know, normal. Relatively. So they, of course, got a little weird about it.
Problems with the Zorkin can be salvaged.
But you know, she's in there. Very nice.
A smoker, but a young one at that. The rest of his organs seems like they can be extracted. The machine should sort the rest. Sierra, engage organic processing sequence.
Lep in the Hood, up to do no good. Lep in the Hood, and to do no good.
Sequence. Stand by, Doctor.
This is how I be eaten. my fucking spaghetti.
Lockdown of the ship by Barristan. Our guards enforced segregation of the ship's crew with an iron fist. Little room to negotiate was had as all refugees became immediate suspects in the eyes of security.
Oh yeah, the 33 Immortals closed beta test is over, and it sucks because I was actually enjoying the game. Yep. Oh, is that it? Is that the end? There's more, right? Check the global achievements. No, there's more. I guess that just means we get to come back to this some other time. Now for our final videos game for tonight, SCP Ground Zero. There's something very powerful about fucking Leprechaun, third movie, in space, fourth movie, in the hood. You'd think you'd start in the hood and then go into space? No. From space to the hood. That's how it is. Every horror movie franchise should follow this example. Fucking imagine The Conjuring in space. Why haven't we had The Conjuring in space? The Conjuring in space. Fucking Annabelle. Zero gravity. Demons floating through the air. Fucking insane. That would get me to go watch a Conjuring movie in theaters. Dude. Here's another idea that I've been cooking. Gabriel from Malignant versus Annabelle from The Conjuring. I want to see him fucking fight. I want to see Gabriel, like, start spawning little wooden Gabriels attached to other puppets and dolls and such, and then they fight Annabelle. I want to see how fucking stupid this shared universe could possibly get. I don't like that new design for 137 or 173. Like, splattering the original colors over a new body just doesn't look too good. It's too long, yeah. Make him stubbier. Like, I respect that the artist behind the original image didn't want their work being used unjustly any further. Yeah, I prefer the one where it's just a bunch of chunks of, like, it's a much chunkier design, but I like it more. Yeah, 173 looks best when it's a strange, unfamiliar design that, like, looks fucked up and weird and like a kid might have made it a little. not to imply the original artist's image that was stolen. Yeah, they need more programmers. Listen, after Hefty Smurf left the U.S. military, it's just never been the same. Fun challenge for people in the military. Fun fact for people in the military. If you all set yourselves on fire, they can't ignore your protests. Freed from ad jail, hell yeah. I get the distinct feeling this is just... Wait, I recognize this room layout. This is a containment breach clone. This is a containment breach clone. I've played this before. If you've played SCP Containment Breach, you've probably played this. I'm not interested in further humoring it. I've already played this a million times before. I've already gotten scared by 173. I'm getting out of here. Oh, the way I was sitting, fucked up my knee. I'm gonna turn on my little fan. It's real hot out today. Like, I had to go pick up some new coffee whitener and some sugar. And, let me tell ya. Wasn't no cakewalk. I didn't expect that fucking blister to pop up right underneath one of my toes, but eh. That's fine. Oh, I'm getting distracted. I'm getting off into the weeds. Insane view count this stream, by the way. It means a lot to me that everyone showed up. Well, I guess you're gonna have to show up more often then. Whoa. I'm sorry. That's disrespectful. You have your own stuff going on. You have more important stuff going on. I can't force you to be here all the time. Damn, he's got to work on a new model sometime. Well, hey, if you need someone to do some rigging work for you for free, I don't mind. All right, let's see. Hey, you know what? Where's my karaoke scene? Auto rigging? What? That's not a thing. Now let's just kill the set list. We'll do whatever. Oh, okay. I have doubts about that the quality of that, but who the fuck am I, you know? It doesn't work well. I didn't think it would. The part of the appeal is that it looks fucked up. Yeah. You know what? I see it. Now that you put it that way, I can understand. A nice emote. Oh, yeah. Fun fact, by the way. The fact that I'm going to be playing Bowser's Inside Story is the direct inspiration for the big and round emote. It's fucking very powerful reason to have a big and round emote, you know? All right, 45 minutes. We can do some karaoke. I'm going to 3 hours today. All right, let's see. Let's start with Spiral of Ants.
Over and over, the pheromones, the overwhelming harmony, consuming the colony, the circle rules your life. Chop, chop, don't want to be late. Lift up and carry your weight. You've got no choice but to dance in a spiral of ants. True bugs might laugh in your face. Don't fret, you're leading the race. Don't let the bastard step on your hands. In a spiral of ants, you can't remember where you came from. You can't remember where you're going. You can't remember knowing. You are one ant. Over, it's over. The pheromones, the self-avoiding odyssey, consuming the colony. The circle rules your life. Now, now, don't run out of breath. Don't feel surrounded by death. Take the wheel, this could be your chance. In a spiral of ants, false bugs, you'll soon be alone. See how they drop like a stone. You're free now, forever to dance in a spiral of ants. Now you remember where you came from. Now you remember where you're going. You've got to keep it flowing. You are one ant over and over. The pheromones, the overwhelming harmony, consuming the colony, creating its own gravity. Before we knew it, we became a hurricane, and the bugs who laughed got blown away as we proclaimed the circle rules your life.
Yes, this song is about the ant death spiral. The iconic ant death spiral, where they just run in circles until they all fucking die. If one wanted to be shallow and pedantic, they could try to spin it into a very biting criticism of capitalism and how it causes everyone to just repeat things until they die. But I don't want to be shallow and pedantic. I want to talk about cock and penis. I don't know, maybe we could consult how he feels about it based on his song Reaganomics. The real trickle down is the piss on Reagan's grave. And, you know, let's keep this going. Let's go No-Eyed Girl next. Fuck it, Lemon Demon, why not? Ooh, there's a remastered karaoke. Oh, but it doesn't have the... You know what, let's just go with the top result. I listened to this album a lot during the summer I was homeless, by the way. Oh, knowing what we know, knowing what we don't know, this is gonna change our world. Feeling how I feel, I'll accept the unreal. If you'd be my no-white girl. From nowhere, mankind can't go there. Too much light, blinding white. Your matter tells mine to scatter. It's all right. It's all right. From the moment that we met, I've been awake like I never been awake in all my life. If I spoke your language, I could tell you how I feel, but your language isn't real. In every myth, there's a little bit of truth, but I cannot say a thing. I cannot say a thing without proof, oh no. Thank you.
Oh, knowing what we know, knowing what we do not know, this is gonna change our world. I might go insane if I learn your full name. If you be my no-eyed girl from nowhere, mankind can't go there, too much light. Blinding white emotions, human implosions, it's alright, it's alright. Right before the kiss, I noticed something in the air. Molecules existed when there should have been none there. Chemical reactions with the surface of your skin. Some will say my actions let the no-white people in. And I do it all again. And I do it all again.
I'm not gonna lie. On the poll, where I offered people the choice between this, Don't Boo from Dawn Brothers, and I think the opening to Kamen Rider Amazon, I was kind of hoping people would vote for the one I wanted. I wanted to do Don't Boo, the song I've been using as an outro for a little bit, because it's just so fucking good. I love it. But now I have to do this song that I fucking suck at, so I was like, I guess I'll do Don't Boo some other time.
Why am I getting recommended a video with a thumbnail of a Digital Circus Pomni Soyjack? Digital Circus Pomni Soyjack. It's like going right at the screen, and it's pointing backwards, and it's pointing at music notation. Digital Circus Pomni Soyjack. I still have to watch the second episode for that, by the way. No spoilers. If you spoil, I'm going to have Chunky kill you. YouTube is a hellscape, and there's no better hellscape out there, baby. All right, and you know, let's hit another one. Let's keep going. Yeah, he's the fattest doll I have. He's double stuffed. His full name is Chunkatello Chunky Kong, and I love him. He's very powerful. I love him. All right, we're doing a remastered karaoke, and I'm going to be following lyrics from the comment section. Let's see how well I do this. I forget that it starts right out the gate. Okay. My mind's this cave, so dark, no moon. No stars, no sound, just hearts
and walls of Archbeck. Strange things happen for no reason. That's all I know. That's where I was supposed to go into the next part. Okay. Try again. Take two. This cave, so dark, no moon, no stars, no sound, just hearts and walls of art. Strange things happen for no reason. Mime. Fuck. I did it right once before. I'll do it right. I'll do the rest right, okay? My mind's this cave, so dark, no moon. No stars, no sound, just hearts and walls of art. These creatures I've seen, some of them edible, some of them mean. That's all I know. I'm not like you. You fly, you burn my eyes, you speak in my mind. Your kind all died when you arrived. You making fire, strange things happen for no reason at all. I can't help you. You're not human. You're not animal. My mind's this cave. Fuck, no. Fuck. I got most of it right. You know what? Fuck it. I'll drop this. I'll save it for a real cover. And then you'll hear the full thing. I did most of it right here. The part I was fucking up on had backup vocals that are missing. You understand. And you know, let's do Eighth Wonder. I could do Man-Made Object again, but I've already done a full cover of that, and it's a really good cover. You should go listen to it when you have the time. Let's get that turned up a little.
more. Louder. Louder.
Extra clever. Earthbound spirit. Ghost in the form of a mongoose. And I have hands, and I have feet. I'll never die. I am a freak. Hello, I'm here. I'm living in the wall. I know I might be small, but I am a freak. Thou wilt never know what I am. I am the fifth dimension, and I'll split the atom. And you see me, you're paralyzed. Pillar of salt, you're mummified. Hello, I'm here, I'm living in the wall. I know I might be small, but I am the eighth wonder. And I was born 1852, and I was born in India, and I shall hunt like the bugger with such weird noise and clanking chains. Hello, I'm here, I'm living in the wall. And I might be small, but I am a freak. I say vanished to underground. Jim, let me go. I watch like hell, and I have hands, and I have feet. I'll never die. I am a freak. Hello, I'm here, I'm living in the wall. I know I might be small, but I am the eighth wonder. Eighth wonder of the world. You'll never get to see. What in the name of God can I be?
I'm so sorry if that peaked my mic. It fucked my hearing a little. I heard that peak. I really need to get a new microphone soon. You can find one on the throne wish list. I don't advertise this a lot because it always seems like begging when I do. Right. Well, I'll take a little moment between songs. Like nothing's happening in this part. There's two different gift collections on the throne wish list. If you so choose, if you want to get a little wild with it and pay for some stuff. Well, anything that's really expensive, I have set to crowdfunding so multiple people can contribute to things. How do you feel about this woman? Ambivalent. I have no strong feelings about this woman. A couple of the items up there are a new microphone and an actual audio mixer. But if you decide you don't want to help pay for work equipment, that's fine. There's a different category for like non-work related stuff. Nothing too wacky.
Let's see. You know what? I'm going to see if I'm strong enough now. Fly my wings, karaoke. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not going to fuck around. Every time I hear this song, right around the line, is my thirst for normalcy so odd, I start tearing up. Because of what Limbus Company has fucking done to my brain. And I'm going to try to do it live. Fly, broken wings, I know you are still with me. All I need is a nudge to get me started. Fly, broken wings, to somewhere we can be free. Closer to our ideal. Teary-eyed, once gentle soul, I watched as you rotted away. The mirror says that I still remember hope. You're doing what you love. Isn't that enough? Isn't that enough? A genius, perfect job. Isn't that enough? Isn't that enough? Again and again, you lock me down. When I lock me down, we stake me to the ground. The soil gave me warmth. Please die, little dreams, kill the camellias in me. Wouldn't it be easier to just give in? Why are these hands chasing? Is my thirst Fuck, it happened again. It happened again. Yeah. Project Moon's trick. Got me again. Fuck. It hit the exact line where I start almost crying and I locked up again. I need to fucking start over again. I need to start over again. Two minutes and 8 seconds in. That's always where it ends. Take two. I'm doing it this time. Fly, broken wings, I know you are still with me. All I need is a nudge to get me started. Fly, broken wings, to somewhere we can be free. Closer to our ideal. Teary-eyed, once gentle soul, I watched as you rotted away. The mirror says that I still remember hope. Ooh, 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 ooh. You're doing what you love. Isn't that enough? Isn't that enough? A genius, perfect job. Isn't that enough? Isn't that enough? Again and again, you lock me down. You stake me to the ground. The soil gave me warmth.
Please die, little dreams. Kill the camellias and me. Wouldn't it be easier to give in? Why are these hands chasing dreams out of my reach? Is my thirst for normalcy odd? Fly, perfect wings, where have you been? Bring me to the mind that got us started. Fly, perfect wings, show them who I can be. For the one last time, if you will. That's all.
I fucking did it! I fucking did it!
I fucking did it. That's all that matters. I don't give a shit if I missed maybe a little bit of that last part. I fucking did it. I fucking did it. Oh. Well, now what? We still have 15 minutes left. I could try and do String Theocracy again. But my cover for that is already dog shit enough. You don't need me to be dog shit at it again live on stream. I seriously need to take down some old covers and redo them now that I'm a little better at them. You know what? I'm curious. Are you shitting me? There's no actual off vocal version of the Don't Boo Dawn Brothers. Fuck. That's a MIDI. That is a MIDI. That is not what I'm looking for. Oh, there we go. There's the official one. Don't put a call, don't put a call, don't get a urete. And you know what? I'll save that for later. Do something else. You're doing that. No, I have to get my mind out of the fucking vortex. Yi Song's trick. I need to stop letting Yi Song's trick get me. Yi Song's trick. You will cry every time you hear this fucking song. You know what? Yeah. Most of what I like, King Gizzard.
Most of what I like is given to me by the one that I love, bears the onus every time. Technically, I don't deserve to live this kind of life. perturbed by what I might. I'm changing every time.
I fucked that up. I need to get out of Yi Song's despair trap.
Most of what I like is given to me by the one that I love, bears the onus every time. Technically, I don't deserve to live this kind of life, perturbed at what I might become, unchanging every time. Ecstasy is what I'm needing, I'm bleeding from the eyes. You always shut your eyes when you look me in the eyes. Always caressing the ropes which I frayed. The corpse that I'm dressing should never be displayed. Should never be displayed. Should never be displayed. Face to face is nice, but sharper than a knife. I teeter on its edge, just waiting to be sliced. Returning home brain dead, and you inject the life. Appeal to me, love. Remake, rebuild, revive. Rest of it is what I'm bleeding, a laxative to cry. You always shut your eyes when you look me in the eyes. Always caressing the robes which I fray. The corpse that I'm dressing should never be displayed. 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 Should never be displayed.
You got the idea. Alright, give me a quick couple seconds to edit around the let me just check Steam real quick. Okay, good. My plans for the summer are good to go. Mario. Luigi. And that's going to be the weekdays. I want people to at least have a little idea what I'm doing. I should start preparing my weekly schedules before stream. Sunday slop markdown. Here we go. So a little anecdote while you wait for me to hurry up with the schedule. So last night, I made the mistake of installing High on Life It's true. I did that. I don't know why I did it. It was just there. And I decided to do it. That game reminded me that we need both Rick and Morty fans and Rick and Morty show staff to be systematically tracked down and shot. I want Justin Roiland hung in front of the fucking White House. I'm never going to forgive that motherfucking guy. It was calling to me. Yeah, I craved the shit game, and I was surprised when I got an even worse game than expected. All right, yep. Looking good. Just need to adjust the dates. Yep, save that to schedule. Hang on, file, save as. That bad, yeah. We need Justin Roiland fucking dead for what he has done to comedy writing. Like, I'm not gonna lie. At one point the game bugged out and my gun just started fucking insulting me despite the fact that I was doing what it was fucking asking me. Like, I was already doing the thing it wanted me to do. We need Justin Roiland dead. It's not that he deserves it. It's that it's for the general betterment of the human collective consciousness. We need him fucking dead. Get rid of him. Get him out of here. All right. I know what you're looking for. I know what you're waiting for. Roger, we need the schedule. Come get some. So until we finish Partners in Time, which probably won't even take a full week, we have Monday, Partners in Time, Tuesday, Partners in Time, Wednesday, Partners in Time, Thursday, Partners in Time, Friday, Shin Megami Tensei 5 Vengeance. They finally finished making the game. Yeah, I'm surprised. Atlus took so long with the enhanced re-release of Shin Megami Tensei 5. I didn't think they were going to release it. But here we are. And then Saturday, I'm offline as usual to spend time with my family. And Sunday, you think just because we're doing White Boy Summer, the summer of marathons, I'm missing Sunday slop? No. Sunday slop is eternal. Long broadcast tonight. I'm going to make myself a big smoky. Big smoky. But before I go, yeah, Sunday slop, essential to White Boy Summer. I want you to know that I keep getting recommended this video uploaded 7 hours ago, probably uploaded when I woke up. The Hidden Importance of Asgore and Toriel's Divorce in Chapter 3, Deltarune Theory / Analysis. Thematically important divorce. Thematically important divorce. alright. Yeah, it's called divorce. Pretty sure some of my regulars, including myself, have had a thematically important divorce in our lives. All right, I'm becoming evil. I'm gonna start the outro music. Thank everyone for showing up. Big turnout today. Means the world to me. I'll see you all sometime. See you all tomorrow, I suppose. Is there anyone worth rating on right now? No. Love yourselves, love others, tell people you care about that you care about them, and that they should fucking tune in for that partner push. And of course, crank your dick like it owes you money. I'll see you tomorrow. Don't put a top dice, you go, oh, don't let it, what I want.